What is up, guys? Moritz here with another video. So are you a software developer looking to relocate to Europe? If so, in this video I'm going to be breaking down the salaries for junior and senior software developers in various countries in Europe, including Germany, France, the UK, the Netherlands, Ireland, Italy, Sweden, Denmark, Finland, Luxembourg, and Belgium. And if you're interested in more detailed overviews of individual countries on this list, let me know by smashing that like button, subscribing to this channel, and letting me know which countries you're interested in, because there's a lot of differences in terms of the visas, salaries, and special tax regimes that you can take advantage as an expat working in Europe. So do let me know if that's something you'd be interested in seeing, and I'll make more videos about this topic. So without further ado, let's just jump right into it. So why would you even want to work in Europe? So Europe has a lot to offer software developers, with many startups having started in Europe, as well as more established companies having set up regional offices in Europe to service the European market. In fact, there are about 5.5 million people working in Europe as software developers, and the European Commission has recently issued a study which shows that there's a shortage of vacancies of nearly 500,000 jobs. That is why more than half of tech executives said that recruiting software developers was their number one challenge in their business. Europe also has a lot to offer in terms of work-life balance, having 5-day work weeks, 8-hour work days, plenty of vacation time, as well as flexible working arrangements. So since many European countries are facing shortages in terms of finding suitable applicants, they're increasingly looking abroad to fill those vacancies, and as a result have put in place different packages in order to attract foreign talent to the country when it comes to salary, benefits, as well as special tax regimes and visas that have been put in place to attract foreign software developers to European countries. And as you'll see in this video, European salaries for software developers are generally higher than most other countries around the world. So I'll start this list by covering the country that has the highest salary for software developers in Europe, which is Switzerland. Software engineers in Switzerland will typically earn about 61,000 Swiss francs per year, or about 3,800 euros per month after taxes. On the other end of the spectrum, the highest paid software engineers in the country typically earn around 190,000 Swiss francs per year, before taxes, which equals a net monthly salary of 10,000 euros per month after taxes. However, the average salary for software engineers is closer to 125,000 Swiss francs per year, or 7,000 euros per month after taxes. So while Switzerland has the highest salary for software engineers, it also has one of the highest costs of living. So if you're interested more about the cost of living in Switzerland, you should check out this video I made about the cost of living in Switzerland, as well as this video about reasons why you should move to Switzerland. So while Switzerland's not known for its tech scene, because of its favorable tax regime, a large number of multinational corporations have established operations in Switzerland. So you can find jobs at big companies like Google, Microsoft, Salesforce, Cisco, SAP, IBM, and Oracle. These are just a few of the companies that operate in Switzerland. So France is another country in Europe that is trying to attract startups to set up in France. And as a result, they've put in place a number of different measures in order to make establishing a tech company more attractive in France. In fact, French President Macron has even said that he wants to establish 10 tech giants in Europe by 2030 that are valued at least 100 billion euros each. And as a result, he has put in place special visas for tech workers, as well as established several incubators in places like Paris. So the starting salary in France for a software developer is only about 23,000 euros per year before taxes, or 1,500 euros per month after taxes. However, the highest paid software engineers in the company earn closer to 74,000 euros per year pre-tax, or 3,900 euros per month after taxes. However, the average salary for software developers in France is around 47,000 euros per year, which equals about 2,700 euros per month after taxes. Which is great, because if you get a job offer of at least 37,000 euros per year, you qualify for France's tech visa, which allows non-EU nationals to come to France and work in the tech sector. Moving on to the biggest country in Europe and one of the most popular ones for software developers, let's look at the salaries of software developers in Germany. So there are currently over 800,000 people working as software developers or software engineers in Europe, and the number is only expected to grow in the coming years. Germany is also experiencing a shortage in software developers within the country as a whole, but particularly in cities like Cologne and Munich. As a software developer in Germany, you can expect to earn a minimum pre-tax salary of 40,000 euros per year, which gives you a monthly salary
of around 2,400 euros per month after taxes. However, the average salary of a software developer is closer to 54,000 euros per year before taxes, which equals a net monthly salary of around 3,100 euros per month. If you are a more experienced developer, you should be able to negotiate a salary closer to 70,000 euros per year or 3,900 euros per month after taxes.
When thinking of startups in Europe, most people initially think of cities like London, Paris, or Berlin. But actually, the Swedish capital, Stockholm, has the highest number of software companies per capita in Europe and the second highest per capita in the world behind Silicon Valley. If you want to know how successful their startup scene is, just look at a few of the companies that have come out of Sweden in recent years, including Skype, Spotify, Klarna, and Candy Crush. This strong tech scene means that there are currently 175,000 people working in the sector within the country. So the starting salary for a software engineer in Sweden is 41,000 euros per year, or about 2,200 euros per month after taxes. With the average salary currently sitting around 59,000 euros per year, or just over 3,000 euros per month after taxes. If you're a more experienced software developer, you can expect to earn around 73,000 euros per year, or 3,700 euros per month after taxes. So Luxembourg is another attractive option for those wanting to work as a software developer at one of the many banks that have established operations in Luxembourg. Despite the country only having a population of about 600,000 people, more than 10,000 people are currently working as software developers in the country. So the average pre-tax salary for a software developer in Luxembourg is 53,000 euros per year, which equals a net monthly salary around 3,200 euros per month after taxes. However, if you're more experienced or work for one of the large banks that are established in the country, you can expect to earn a higher salary of around 75,000 euros per year or 4,000 euros per month after taxes. My home country, the Netherlands, is another country that has increasingly become more popular for software developers in recent years, with over 300,000 people working as software developers within the country. Recent reports also show that the IT sector in the country is very strong, with opportunities expected to increase by 6% in the coming year. On average, a software developer in the Netherlands can expect to earn between 42 to 48,000 euros per year. This equals a net monthly salary of between 2,600 to 2,900 euros per month after taxes. However, if you come to the Netherlands as an expat, you'll probably earn more than this because the Netherlands has a special 30% tax rule, which allows foreign expats to get a tax-free allowance of 30% of their income. So let me know if you'd be interested in a dedicated video about this topic, because there's quite a few different things you have to do to qualify for this special tax regime. So let me know in the comments below. So despite having the third largest economy, as well as the high overall standard of living, beautiful scenery and great food, Italy actually ranks more towards the bottom of the list in Europe in terms of attractiveness for software developers, mainly due to the low salaries that are offered in the country. However, the country still has plenty of job opportunities because there's a big shortage for IT jobs, particularly in cities like Milan.
As a software developer in Italy, you can expect to earn a minimum pre-tax salary of around 23,000 euros per year, which would give you a monthly salary of around 1,300 euros per month after taxes. However, the average salary of a software developer is closer to 31,000 euros per year before taxes, which equals a net monthly salary of around 1,800 euros per month. If you are a more experienced developer, you should be able to negotiate a salary closer to 50,000 euros per year or 2,700 euros per month after taxes.
So Belgium is another country that has been increasingly putting in place different mechanisms to make their country more attractive to foreign software developers in order to fill the vacancies that they are unable to fill domestically. So many companies are offering special benefits packages in order to attract foreign talent to the country. I've known many software developers who've come to move to Belgium from places like India and have been offered things like relocation packages, paying for their rent, as well as paying for the private education of their children at international schools. Belgium is also attractive in that it is one of the easiest countries in Europe to get citizenship. So for those of you who are not from Europe and want to live in Europe in the long term, this could make Belgium an attractive option for you as well.
As a software developer in Belgium, you can expect to earn a minimum pre-tax salary of 26,000 euros per year, which would give you a monthly salary of around 1,650 euros per month after taxes. However, the average salary of a software developer is closer to 38,000 euros per year before taxes, which equals a net monthly salary of around 2,200 euros per month. If you are a more experienced developer, you should be able to negotiate a salary closer to 55,000 euros per year or 2,800 euros per month after taxes.
Finland is another country which has a lot to offer to expats coming to relocate there, including one of the highest quality of lives overall, as well as arguably one of the best public education systems in the world. However, some expats have a hard time dealing with the lack of sunlight in the winter, with winter days often only having around 6 hours of sunlight per day.
As a software developer in Finland, you can expect to earn a minimum pre-tax salary of around 30,000 euros per year, which would give you a monthly salary of around 1,600 euros per month after taxes. However, the average salary of a software developer in Finland is closer to 45,000 euros per year before taxes, which equals a net monthly salary of around 2,300 euros per month. If you are a more experienced developer, you should be able to negotiate a salary closer to 63,000 euros per year or 3,000 euros per month after taxes.
The UK is another great option for software developers looking to establish themselves in an English-speaking country. Another reason that makes the UK a great option for expats is arguably the easiest country to integrate to and settle down in Europe, as companies are already used to hiring many foreign workers and having them work within their company. I have never felt unwelcome in the 6 years that I personally spent living in the UK, and I think most other expats will feel the same way if they decide to move to the UK.
As a software developer in the UK, you can expect to earn a minimum pre-tax salary of around £26,000 per year, which would give you a monthly salary of around £1,800 per month after taxes. However, the average salary of a software developer in the UK is closer to £38,000 per year before taxes, which equals a net monthly salary of £2,500 per month. If you are a more experienced developer, you should be able to negotiate a salary close to £62,000 per year, or £3,700 per month.
Similar to the UK, Ireland is another good English-speaking option for software developers looking to relocate to Europe. The special corporate tax regime that's in place in Ireland, as well as its status as the only English-speaking country left in the EU since Brexit, means that a lot of large multinational companies have established themselves in Ireland. In fact, over 1,000 companies, including the ones on the screen, have made investments or established a presence within the country. In fact, 9 out of 10 of the biggest IT companies, as well as 8 of the 10 biggest gaming companies, have established operations within Ireland.
As a software developer in Ireland, you can expect to earn a minimum pre-tax salary of around 32,000 euros per year, which would give you a monthly salary of around 2,300 euros per month after taxes. However, the average salary of a software developer in Ireland is closer to 45,000 euros per year before taxes, which equals a net monthly salary of around 2,900 euros per month. If you are a more experienced developer, you should be able to negotiate a salary closer to 68,000 euros per year or 3,900 euros per month.
So that's just an overview of some of the salaries you can expect to earn working in different countries in Europe. If you're interested in a more detailed video about working as a software developer in a specific European country, or this video I made about software developer salaries in other countries around the world, why not subscribe to this channel and commenting in the comment section below. That's all for now. I hope to see you in the next video.